break down, that is very important for you to understand. If we have to understand drama particularly, it is there in novels, I mean, irony is there in all of the writing, all kinds of writing. Irony. We have heard this word. Okay, I will talk about the origin, how this word, there used to be these two characters in Greek writings, Iron and Elizon. So Iron would be a character who would be, who would behave as if he is a fool, who would not behave as if he is very intelligent. Now Elizon would be a character who would brag, who would boast very much about his intelligence, about his brain and all that. But ultimately, in the end, this Iron would turn the tables on Elizon. Yes, he would be the one who would make the maximum benefit of situations. So Iron is a name which eventually it came to be associated with everything which is not very obvious. Yes, so irony is that tool that writers use, and it has, it has this rude sense of dissembling or hiding. You are dissembling, you are hiding yourself. What is actually the case? Jo asal mein hai, aap usko chupa rahe hain. So you are dissembling or hiding what is actually the case, not however in order to deceive, but to achieve special rhetorical or artistic effects. So the writer does not want to hide things from you, but the writer wants to achieve special artistic effects. And that is why he is using this tool that is called irony. So there are these two different types of ironies which are very common. Verbal irony. Verbal irony, as the name suggests, verbal is which is related to your words. Yes, what you speak. So verbal irony is that statement in which the meaning that a speaker implies differs sharply from the meaning that is ostensibly expressed. What you say does not exactly mean what you say, but it means something else. आप समझ रहे हैं? जो आप कह रहे हैं, जैसे सार्कास्म होता है ना, जैसे हम टॉन्ट करते हैं, जैसे हम बोलते हैं, अरे वाह, क्या बढ़िया काम किया है. So you don't mean to say that you have done a good job. What do you mean to say? You have done a very bad job. Yes? You are angry. You are not happy with that. So sarcasm is a form of irony. Yes? So verbal irony is that irony where you say something, but your actual intention or the meaning that you want to express is something else. So there is this example. It is a truth universally acknowledged that a single man in possession of a good fortune must be in want of a wife. This is the opening sentence of a very famous novel by Jane Austen. तो जो लिखा है राइटर ने वो क्या लिखा है? It is a truth universally acknowledged that a single man who is very rich must be in want of a wife, must be willing to marry. There is a single man who is very rich, so he would be willing to marry. This is what the writer writes, but the actual meaning is that every girl wants to marry a rich man. Every girl is looking for a rich man. The actual meaning is that. But what does the writer say? That a single man who is in possession of a good fortune, who is very rich, must be willing to marry, must be wanting to marry. So, likha to ye hai, lekin matlab kya hai? That every girl wants a rich husband. Whenever you are looking for a husband, the first thing that you notice is whether the person is rich or not. This is an example of verbal irony. आपको समझ में आया?
Yes.
The writer writes something, but the actual meaning that he wants to express is something else. That is verbal irony. Is this clear? Okay. The next is dramatic irony. Now, dramatic irony is very simple to understand. We see it every day. We see it in films. We see it on television, and we witness it in the text that we read in novels and in plays. So dramatic irony is that situation that the writer uses where the audience and the writer, they know something which the character in the story does not know. Are you getting it? The writer and the audiences, they know something which the characters in that story do not know. So ऐसा बहुत सारी फिल्म्स में देखा होगा आपने, टीवी सीरियल्स में होता है बहुत बार. There is this secret, big secret, and then the audience know the secret. Obviously, the writer or the director knows the secret, but the characters in that story, they do not know it, and they work according to their ignorance of that fact. So that is dramatic irony. Are you getting it? समझ में आया?
Yes, ma'am.
The writer knows there is certain fact, there is certain situation about which obviously the writer knows because the writer is writing, and he tells the audience also, he tells the readers also that secret or that situation. But the characters within that narrative or within that drama, they do not know about that fact, and they work in ignorance of those facts or that secret. That is dramatic irony. So it is, let it go. Okay. So it involves a situation in a play or in a narrative. It could be in a play, it could be in a story or in a novel also, in which the audience or reader shares with author. The readers and the author, they share the knowledge of present or future circumstances of which a character is ignorant. The characters are ignorant, but the author and the readers, they know about that situation. So he acts according to his ignorance of that situation, and then ultimately it could end either way. It could end happily for the character, or it could not end happily for the character. But that dramatic tool is known as an irony. I hope this is clear.